Yeah. Yeah.
God be with you. Farewell.
Can we do something about the price?
Well, we can try it.
Are we agreed?
I'd almost shake on it. Almost. All right, so.
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this. God be with you.
So, I prowled around for a while, and I have something for you.
Wonderful! How many did you get?
All three.
So that's all of them. Excellent. Let's hope the burden never hears about my little mistake.
Let's hope not.
Thank you, lad. Here's something for your efforts.
Can you teach me to be a better archer?
Certainly.
I'd like to practice the basics.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Isn't that quite a lot? What about this?
Well now, a little more and we'll shake on it. Agreed. Now, listen up. Take care now.
I'd like you to show me some hunting tricks.
Certainly.
I'd like to practice the basics.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Isn't that quite a lot? Is this enough?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost. Agreed. Now, listen up. Farewell.
Cannot live by bread alone, but he can't live without it. down.
Leave me be.
Jesus Christ be praised.
I've got some goods here whose owners might miss them.
All right. Let's see what we can do about that. Farewell.
Let's talk about the price.
Well, we can try it.
Are we agreed?
A nice sum. Just lower your demands a little and we'll agree. Finally, a reasonable sum.
A joy to taste.
Good day to you. What do you need?
God be with you.
Can you show me how to repair armor and weapons better?
Certainly.
I'd like to practice the basics.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Isn't that quite a lot? Are we agreed?
Well, a little more and we'll call it a deal. Agreed. Now listen up. Farewell. Farewell.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Well, we can try it.
Is this enough?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost. See now? I knew we'd come to an agreement.
Yeah! Yeah!
Good day to you.
What about the crown? Is it finished?
I'm a man of my word. Of course it's finished. Here you have it. Thank the Lord you found that Moldavite. It wouldn't be the same without it.
Take care now.
The Lord save you. What do you need?
I brought you the crown from the master engraver.
Henry, you are a gem. Look at that Moldavite. Isn't it wonderful? Sophie will look like an angel. So, what's next?
I brought the wine.
Wonderful, wonderful. No wedding is complete without good wine. Find somewhere here to put it down. I'll send for a servant to bring it later. I hope you had no problems acquiring it.
Problems? I don't know the meaning of the word.
As if I didn't know you.
What can I do for you, my lady?
Nothing. You've done enough. And now I'd like to reward you.
That's not necessary, my lady. You taking the time to see me is reward enough.
Come now, Henry. No need for such modesty. I appreciate everything you've done for me, as well as your company. And there's something I'd like to give you. This shirt was my father's. He was built very much like you. Broad shoulders, strong chest. It should fit you just right.
But I can't accept this. It's too valuable.
It's too valuable to be left to the mercy of moths. It doesn't fit my husband well, and I've no one else to give it to. What's more, if you were to leave us again, I'd like you to have something to remember me by, so you don't forget me.
I could never forget you, my lady.
Well then, won't you try it on at least?
What? Right now?
Why not? Don't worry, I won't look. I'll turn my back.
And what if your husband comes in?
He won't. Neither will anyone else.
All right, then.
Take care. I feel truly blessed to have you here. So long I yearned for young company. I really feel God heard my prayers and sent you to me.
I'm ready.
My, you do look handsome. As fine as any gentleman. When I was a little girl, there were always lots of other children around and young men and women of the court. It was so merry. I always hoped it would be like that when I was grown up too. But it was not God's plan.
You and Sir Divish had no children?
No. No, alas, we were not blessed. Twice I was with child, but they did not live. And now I fear there's no hope for me.
My lady. Forgive me, my lady. I shouldn't have.
I don't mind.
Better put that weapon away, or you'll be out.
I'm honored that you should come to me.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin.
Good luck to you.
Mother of... Hey, what do you think you're doing? Get the hell out of here.
God be with you, Henry. Hey, how'd you get so fucked up?
I want to get better at fist fighting.
Certainly.
I'd like to hone my skills.
First, you have to have some skills to hone.
Well, I'll think it over.
Goodbye.
Good day to you.
How's trade? Any trouble around these parts?
Nothing we can't handle.
May the Lord watch over you.
Here's your share.
My share of what? What the hell are you on about?
Well, that thing with Thomas... somehow his ring ended up with us.
Thomas? Who's he?
That bastard of a foreman at the mill in Adechkov, where you got us the job.
Are you out of your tiny mind? If anyone finds out you robbed him, we'll all be fucked.
Take it easy. It wasn't theft, exactly. We all know he stole that ring himself. So if it comes out, he'll be in the shit too. He'll keep his mouth shut.
Where'd you find someone willing to buy and not ask too many questions?
It wasn't easy. Then Fritz thought of Andrew.
Andrew?
The innkeeper here. They say all sorts of things about him.
And how did it go with him?
Well, first he didn't seem too keen. But when he saw the ring, he bought it off us. Actually, I'm not surprised. After all, we'll spend all the money on booze here anyway.
What now? What will you do next?
Now that you mention it...
Out with it, then. What have you thought up now?
I can't help myself. It's force of habit. We tried to be good at Sassau.
So good that you punched a novice in the mouth.
Exactly. We broke our backs working in the mill.
While you eyed up the miller's daughter.
And they drove us out. The only worthwhile thing we did recently was give that wastrel a thrashing, take his ring, and sell it to Andrew.
I'm not sure I like where you're going with this.
And where's that? No one in the country gives a damn about the law. And if we knock some thief over the head in the woods, or ambush some wagon with supplies for Sigismund's soldiers, I won't lose any sleep over it.
Those swine deserve even worse. But that's what Sir Hanish is here for, isn't he? What can we do?
Wake up, for Christ's sake! It's war! They skewered your parents, didn't they? They fucking burned down our fucking village, didn't they? Don't you give a damn about that?
Of course I fucking do.
And now, there's a herd of swine ransacking skeletons. Those fuckers are trampling over the ashes of Jeremiah, and Desmond, and Siegfried, and Tristan.
Let's chop those bastards to pieces, one after the other.
I can't let it go, Hal. Even if I have to do it on my own, I'll put the fear of God into those bastards.
You won't be alone.
I knew we could rely on you, Hal. I knew it.
So, what's the plan?
Well, I thought Andrew the innkeeper here could help us, but he's nervous. Best ask Chris. He sorted out selling the ring, and he knows Andrew better.
All right, I'll do that. I want more money for that ring.
And why is that?
Because we're really good mates.
Nice try.
I'd like you to teach me how to be better at stealth.
Certainly.
I'm interested in more advanced techniques.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Isn't that quite a lot? Agree?
That's a poor offer. Agreed. Now listen up.
Hey, how'd you get so fucked up?
I hear you've got a plan to fleece the local villains.
Be nice, wouldn't it? Otherwise, we soon won't have a pot to piss in.
And the innkeeper here could lend a helping hand.
Exactly.
So what's the problem?
He reckons we're not up to it. You should try and talk him into it. You were always good at that. Oh, and tell him I sent you, so he doesn't send you packing.
Do you know how I might set about convincing Andrew?
Mention money.
That's all.
Aye. Often the innkeeper's as greedy as they come.
Fritz sent me. I'd like to talk about...
you'd like some wine from my cellar? I have it right here, in the back.
No, I wanted to steal...
Yes, of course it's good. I have it right here, in the back.
Yes, of course. Lead the way.
May the Lord watch over you.
So, Fritz sent you, did he?
Aye. This was his idea.
Look, lad, I'm fond of Fritz. I knew his old ma, but Matthew, he's insane. Robbing people.
Only those that deserve it.
And you think his lordship won't mind? Have you any idea the kind of shit you can get into? I don't believe you're up to it.
Why don't you believe us? There's four of us, and there's a fucking war on. If we're careful, no one will catch us.
It's still too risky.
There's plenty of coin in it, and almost no risk for you.
So, there'd be a share in it for me, eh?
A handsome one.
We'll see if you're up to it. You'll need a disguise.
What disguise?
Use your head. You can never be sure no one will see you.
Yeah, that's true. We'll have to put on some other clothes or...
Dress up as humans.
What?
It's obvious, isn't it? Everyone knows they're looting. If someone's robbed by humans, no one will investigate.
That's true. But I'll have to get some human clothes.
A captain's. And three sets of them.
What?
On account of the helmets. No one will recognize you with them on.
And where the hell am I supposed to get it?
There's gangs of humans around Skelets. I've got a good idea where to find them from. Passers-by.
I'm supposed to attack a human camp.
A minute ago, you were full of yourself. And now, all of a sudden, you've lost your nerve.
But the whole fucking camp?
The scouts are deserters. Most likely the ones who are trying to skive off or take easy pickings. And even humans have to sleep.
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
Well, well. Now, what have we here? What's that he's bringing us? I'll slay you, you scum!
I'll let you go, but it'll cost you.
Very well.
My respects to you.
I've got some goods here whose owners might miss them.
All right. Let's see what we can do about that.
Let's have a word about the price.
Well, we can try it.
Is this enough?
a nice sum. Just lower your demands a little and we'll agree.
Aye, that would do it.
God, what a stink! Speak quickly.
I came to apologize to you.
Then apologize, and make it good.
Look at me.
Yeah? What?
Can't you see?
What exactly am I supposed to see?
Anguish. Terrible anguish. I'm so miserable without you.
Henry, you're such a jester. Oh, look at me. I'm in anguish.
But I am, though. Really, I'm sorry.
I know. Me too.
Will you give me another chance?
What else can I do when you're in such anguish?